On. Start streaming.
What are you doing, Trump?
Fuck off, Ross! Oh my god!
Jesus Christ. Are you peeking? Or is that me?
I don't know.
Oh, don't peek.
Don't peek at me.
No peeking, please.
This is the point, everybody, where we diagnose issues and just generally have a little chit-chat before we start. So, hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello, puppets.
How's it going?
So you're the guys who are going to tell us whether this is working.
Or not working.
Whilst I search for the necessary things that we need.
Yeah, that was definitely me peeking at the start.
Was it actually peeking?
No, it's just because I shouted a lot.
But did it actually peek?
A little bit. Maybe turn me down a bit. Prick. Yeah, I turned me down a little bit.
Should be fine on the recording, but like on this... If it's coming out on that peaky, then
it might also be two of the. Watching two streams at the same time. So my ears just bled.
It's really informative, mate. Really informative. Okay.
Sounds alright at the moment.
Let's try and find some interesting stories. I'm like. You both got one. You both got an interesting, funny news story.
Oh, it's hilarious.
I bet you haven't prepared one yet.
It's so funny. Do you know what I love? Emote spam in chat. I don't. I fucking hate it. So Ezra, how is everybody? How you doing? Thanks for tuning in, all six of you, as the YouTube stats say. Are you well? Are you eating healthily? If you're fucking not, I swear to God, I'm going to tell your parents. The sound keeps cutting out, apparently.
Okay.
Which it will. We love that issue, and...
We don't know how to overcome it.
It is because of three webcams going into Ross's computer. It happens.
However, if it continues to do it, is it worth doing it?
What do you mean?
Well, is it going to keep...
Well, we can restart in the hopes that it goes... The thing is... I'm going to listen to myself for a second, so I'm going to sound weird.
Okay.
So, how does this sound? It sounds okay for me.
Okay.
But it might be because people are looking on different settings? I don't know. It hasn't cut out for me once yet, me listening to this back.
I've listened to it a little bit.
How is it, Smith?
Every so often you get a big fat one, but not very often.
Big chunky one. Wow, there's 1,821 watching now, which is a big leap from six. I think the thing is, it sort of sorts itself out the more we go, I think. As an engineer once said to me, you just got to let it ride itself out. Let things balance in the force. And I don't think he had a
fucking
clue.
Did he say it like that?
No, he didn't, not at all.
My hair's really bothering me today.
Is it?
Yeah.
What's up with it?
It's just not right.
No? Not feeling it? Can we live shave it?
Sometimes it was
live shave. Head. You want to live shave your head, mate?
Yep.
To the scalp. Scalp you.
People are saying that the sound's okay now. There will be cuts, but the fortunate thing is this is all going to go onto YouTube and iTunes afterwards. So even if you have issues watching it live now, don't worry. The full thing is going to be available to rewatch. At some point in the future, don't worry.
When though, Trot? When?
I don't know, actually. When? You tell me.
I don't know.
We don't have the answers fully.
We don't have the answers. That's the thing.
Cool. So, I'm pretty... Are you guys ready?
Well, hold on. One sec.
I don't know. I thought I found a story, but then I'm not sure if it's...
Not funny enough.
In poor taste. This thing...
Oh.
Some of these are just in poor taste.
Mm.
It's always nice to have something that's too bad.
Essentially what we do, though, isn't it?
Essentially.
Is that door closed? No, it's not.
Nope.
Oh, thanks.
You're going for a hat?
You're doing a shin.
Going for a hat, mate.
If your hair's bad, everybody, life lesson, put a hat on.
Try to say
shin. But if you're like me,
bad.
Where I have an oversized head.
How was that better than before?
There you go, guys.
See it
yet. Proper hat.
I have to wait 30 seconds to catch up.
Nuts.
It's cold inside.
The aircon's actually going to go off really soon, so you're going to get really hot. People are spamming boob with emotes in chat, which is fantastic. I'm going to flag that. as spam. So, well done. You lost. You lost the game of emotes. I think the YouTube chat sucks in comparison to Twitch.
Yeah, the only reason like we're mainly using YouTube is because more people actually get to see it.
Yeah, and, like, essentially.
Unfortunately, it does cut off a few people from watching the live version, but it will go... It'll upload straight away onto our channel,
where it's a much better
even more
flow.
People can get to see it. Basically, it's literally a case of the fact that more people get to see it and enjoy it. And, you know, if you can't watch it live, that sucks. But, like, it will be up there. It'll be up there, so you can always enjoy it.
Smith, I've just seen your hat.
Yeah, no, fucking, he looks like he's about to rob a house.
It suits you. Like, this stash doesn't suit me. Am I right? It's not that bad, Smith. So, your hat's okay.
It's just... Yeah, it's a hat, guys.
He'll be all right. At least
we're just
going to
get on with it. I'm not. Yeah, that's not that bad.
Ross is not happy with the story.
I'm just trying to find a fucking good story.
Oh, okay.
Well, okay. Well, let me just find a couple of decent headlines, and then we'll just fucking roll with it.
You're nuts, Ross. The thing is, me and Smith can ham up our news story so as to waste all the time you would have had for yours. Mm. How's that sound? Or you can just completely make up some news.
Should I make up some news, mate?
Yeah, make up some news from nothing.
Well, I should make,
we'll
make
just
up
say
some news.
It's true.
I don't know.
Oh,
I'm adjusting
so,
it.
If you tuned in and you don't know what the hell is going on, you're confused, you're on YouTube, something. This is live, which is pretty cool. We do hat chats all the time. I mean, we do them so often and so concisely to a routine schedule.
We did one a month ago.
Yeah.
So,
this is just a podcast, so don't expect anything amazing visually apart from our faces.
Yeah, visually, it's not. We're not playing a game.
We're not playing a game. We're just chatting away like a podcast, and it will go on iTunes like a real ass podcast does.
Exactly.
If you watch Sips, think that podcast he started recently, Rambling with Sips, but he did it after us. You know, we're the originals.
Are we the originals? Is that
what
been
it doing
is?
This since 2011, I think, or earlier potentially.
Something
know.
Like that.
Pretty
Trot?
Soon after.
Something
we
like
the
that.
There's like 34 episodes already on iTunes. If you get bored of this one, there's loads of others who are way more funny.
There it goes.
Oh, there goes the aircon. So from
be...
here onwards, we're gonna get more and more hot and sweaty. So that's what really adds to.
So I've got this winter hat on.
That's what it's all about.
Cool. So Ross, you just gonna wing it?
Fuck off, Trot. Jesus, I'm trying to fucking do this.
No.
Jesus.
I'm sorry. I'm also very aroused.
Don't be, mate.
I got a light on me now.
Yeah,
which is
so
quite nice. So is Ross. So the,
just
we got like
a bit there.
Office lights which point directly down on mine and Ross's face in particular. Smith's a little bit better because the light's like more in front of him.
No, mine's horrible.
Yeah, it's not great. But
he's got
now,
his fucking hoodie on as well now.
Now we got lights.
You can't see it yet, Trot, but Jesus Christ.
I've still got to catch up. I don't really want to watch our face anymore because I'm about to vomit profusely at watching our faces.
Fairs, mate.
Oh, there is one story here that's just... The headline made me click on it, but, I mean, it is pretty harsh.
Yeah, I don't know if you want that.
Want harsh, mate.
So I read
we
you the headline
funny.
Just before? Like, it's not...
Go on, get a little taster. Little test.
Mother gave son fatal morphine for a laugh.
That's not funny.
That's
at all.
Horrible.
Yeah, but it's the line which says, for a laugh.
Yeah,
it's just like,
who
what?
Decides that that's for a laugh?
she did.
Because she's psychotic, Ross.
It was funny.
It's
for
only funny for her. No
just
one else.
Game for a laugh.
Well, I guess she was. I mean, I don't know whether it was like there was a lot of banter involved. It was just kind of, I could just up the dosage and, yeah.
That's horrible, Ross. That is not funny.
Well, that's why I mentioned it, Trump. That's why it's not going in.
Well, you got a taste of there of something that would have been. Potentially. So, yeah, we're going to go live soon. Once we start a hat chat, that's pretty much it.
Where'd you guys get your stories from?
Ramble from it. I got mine from
Mine's from, like,
Reddit.
Sky News.
From Reddit.
Sky News. I went to, like, all the different sites. And
all of them. All of the ones.
Yeah. Mine's not even that great, to be honest. People need to be more funny in this world. But on a ridiculous scale. But I've got a decent enough news. It'll do.
Okay.
We're changing up the format anyway, but you'll hear all about that once we actually start. Megabants. Banterweight. That's a new one. It's good. Mm. Fuck it, Ross. Just wing it.
Bantamweight isn't actually a weight, though, Trump. So that's how close it is. It's...
I know, but still.
That's Bants, though, for you.
Bants weight. Bantanamo Bay. I use that one a lot.
That's good, I like it.
Any banter puns, put them in the comments now.
Chris Chart, Banterpuns UK. Starting a website.
I'm the Banty Christ.
He is the Banty Christ.
See, the original one I chose wasn't funny at all. I've just read
some of the
article.
Come on, just choose anything and make it funny.
Anything that's
You're
not that same news article.
Just choose anything at all, and we'll just laugh at how shit it is.
Okay.
Just normal news, and we'll laugh our asses off.
Let's get this podcast underway.
Banter Dick Cumberbatch.
Banter Dick Cumberbatch.
Bantalope.
Yeah, bantalope. Yeah, I hunt bantalope.
Banterweight. That's just the same thing.
Same thing.
I
you
said
worse.
Banterbury tails.
Bantasaurus rex.
Bantasia. Oh my god, that is amazing.
Nice.
Bantasia.
The Bantam Menace.
Banty Freeze. Banty Matter Explosives.
The Bantam Menace. That's a good one.
The Bantam Menace, mate.
Bantam Deck. Bantam of the Opera.
I've done all of these.
You have.
And I've done Bantam Deck.
Bantonio Banderas.
Yep, done it.
Bantamime.
Done it.
Bant Pack.
Haven't done
testing
that
audio.
Not good.
I can't test it.
Archbishop of Banbury.
Bantana Montana.
Testing audio.
Banta Montana.
Bantanimous.
Oh, is that audio coming
Antonio
through? It's doubled, guys.
Banteris.
I can hear you, but
it's not double.
No.
Motherfucker.
Banty Mage.
Banty Mage. Double two.
Test.
Nice.
Testing.
Bantalona.
Coming through. It's fine.
Nice, Ross.
What?
Oh no. It's fine. It's all right. Ed Miliband.
Yeah. Ed.
Banter, as in Fanta. Mm. Nice.
Oh, that's rubbish, though, because it's the same as banter, isn't it?
Sexual Bantasies.
Nice.
These are good guys. You're doing well. Mm. Sweat Bants.
Sweat Bants. I like
Sweat
that.
You really like
simple.
That one,
Bantinator. Banter's Gate.
Final Bantasy 7.
I like that.
That was me.
That's good. That was nice, mate.
Okay, Final Fantasy 7.
And of course, the sequel is Final Fantasy 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and.
Breaking Bant.
Breaking Bant, nice.
Bant Chat.
This is where people are leaving, I think. This is where, this is the stage where people realize what they're about to get into, and they're like, oh, actually.
This is just.
Fuck
this is going to be the next hour. We're going to be fucking rambling, but in sectionalized formats because it's a podcast, so we have categories.
How we've done it, yeah.
It's all right. We've got a script. It's all scripted. It's not scripted at all.
So I'm Bantman and you're Robin.
Nice. Thanks. Any more? Couple more?
Yeah, I mean, I could go for a while.
Oh.
You could go for a while. Fair enough.
That's what she said.
But,
nice. All right. Nice. I'm ready to go. Let's fucking do this.
Okay. Well, don't worry. I'm going to just, find a story on the fly.
You're crazy.
I mean, yeah. Let's just do it.
Bante's Inferno.
Bante's. Guys, have you updated your Bantasy football today?
Banter Wave. Fantasy football, nice. The Bantastic Four.
The Bantastic Four. We're like the Bantastic Three.
Bustery Biscuit Bants.
Yeah.
No, that doesn't work.
Banty Establishmentarianism.
Nice.
The
Anything
Pink
with
Banter.
The word Banty in it. Anti.
Banty. Banty histamines. Let's do it. Let's start this podcast.
Alright, I'm sorry.
Banter Call Soul.
Nice.
Game audio is recording for whenever we are ready. So,
okay, wonderful. So for those tuning in right now, this is Hat Chat. It's a podcast. We're going live and it's going to be recorded and put on YouTube afterwards. Don't worry. It's us chatting.
It is.
For an hour or so.
It is called Hat Chat for a reason because
hopefully it'll be entertaining.
Films chatting.
Put it in the background, have a wank. Doesn't matter. You don't have to focus.
Maybe not that. I don't know. You don't have to
well,
be.
Well, I
that.
Am. Are you not?
You worry me with the things
sorry?
You say, Tron.
Why?
It's because it's the things you do when you listen to podcasts.
I just
whack one out.
Ricky Gervais.
Fucking flick on a podcast and jerk off. It's weird, Trot.
Guys, this is all gold. We're wasting this.
Is it?
In the
Are we
preamble.
Wasting it?
I don't know how to turn you up. But I've got your headphones going through a hat and a hoodie, and so you're quite quiet.
Oh, that's your
own
problem.
Fault. That's your own fault, man.
I feel like I shouldn't be punished for my own things, though.
Let's start this shit.
Okay.
Ross, do a pretend intro.
Oh.
I know I'm doing an intro, but like.
Musically.
Musically. Extended edition. Oh shit, it's a breakdown. It's drum bass.
Is that date right on the thing?
No, it's not right.
No, it's cool. Not.
Well, because we were gonna do this podcast last week.
Yeah.
Doesn't
okay.
matter.
Right.
We're real.
We're all ill.
Okay, so Trot, kick her off.
Sup! What hat films, yo? I feel like the start of a rap.
Okay.
I'm Trot and I'm joined by.
Hello.
Who's that?
Who just says hello?
I'm Alex Smith.
That was Alex Smith.
A.K.A. Al Smithy, A.K.A. Smith, A.K.A. that twat
and
over
who's
there.
Who's that third voice?
Oh, that's me. That's Ross. That's Ross Hornby. There you go.
Hello,
thank
Ross
very
Hornby.
Much.
How are you today?
Thanks for the intro, Trot.
Shut up. And we're here today in your eardrums to offend, be crude, crass, politically questionable, and just generally potty mouth for your entertainment for the next hour or so. Somehow we managed to organise this chaos into sections, but for the first time, guys, since we started Hat Chat, big changes are happening to the sections. So without further ado, let's tuck our dicks into our scrotums.
That's not possible.
And three ball our way to the announcement section.
Three ball!
Three balls! Do you remember doing that in school?
No!
Yeah, you didn't do that.
What do you mean?
Like where you used to put your penis in your scrotum and pretend you had three balls.
No, never.
Sorry, what are you talking about?
You didn't do that at primary
school.
What are you telling us that you just did right now?
It used to be a thing you did.
No, it was like, oh, mate. No one did that.
Bants. Mega bands. All right,
you
fine.
You
don't, it's optional.
Jesus
you just
Christ.
Walk with me as I do it.
How do we find him?
Into the announcement section.
How do we find this guy?
What?
It's so weird.
We've got loads of announcements to make.
I'm sorry, I can't. Hold on, I can't keep this head up this whole time. It's boiling.
All right, Smith's wearing a hoodie. If you're just tuning into iTunes podcast, Smith is wearing a hoodie and a hat indoors and the aircon's off.
And the aircon's gone off. Right, okay, we're all good. Let's do this. I can hear a lot better as well.
Let's announce. All right. Hello. All right.
All right.
All right. So right, we're changing the format of Hat Chat. That's crazy.
Is it crazy?
It's nuts.
Doesn't seem that crazy.
Smith's like stunned.
I had to take a minute.
We're trimming down some stuff because we've realised we do a lot of updates and stuff about what Hat Films are doing right now, but at that point in time when you go back and watch it for entertainment purposes, it's completely redundant. Like, we're going to a convention next week and that's cool. It doesn't make sense. So we're removing it from the podcast because it's not really in the format to do so. Oof. And we're adding more entertaining things in. So, also, our gaming section is being phased out. It's gone. We've taken it out back and
shot
it.
We talk about that shit all the time, don't we?
We do talk about gaming
all the time. So it's
kind of like
it's, you know, a passive thing anyway. It shouldn't be. It shouldn't have its own section anyway.
Gaming's
good.
We had to take it out because all Ross plays is FIFA, all I play is Dota, and all Trot plays is Pokemon.
yeah. But we'll talk about, like, gaming and shit in all the other sections anyway. It just won't have its own section because it's...
Tell us your favourite game so we can mock it now!
What, mine?
No, Pokemon Shuffle.
Is that a game? It's a thing.
Or
it's free. It's free to play, but you only get 5 goes and you have to pay. Anyway, enter Hat Chat. Hat Chat is getting a section within Hat Chat.
Nice.
Because it's like
came up
Yo
with
Dog
it in the morning.
Exhibit
this morning.
Shit.
Literally
the best
on the way
idea, the best name you could come up with was the already existing name of the general podcast.
Yeah.
Well, so, we were walking in this morning. We thought, well, why don't we have a section where we just chat?
Yeah.
And then we'll call that section the Hat Chat.
Yeah.
And so within the Hat Chat, we've gone...
We can do more anything in this section.
On. We can Hat Chat inside the chat.
We walked in separately this morning.
What do you mean? Well, I was chatting to Ross.
Yeah, no, we walked in.
You were off on your own.
You were off on your own, mate.
Fuck.
Trot was going to walk in. Sorry, let's just...
Stuff that can happen.
No, let's just clear this up for Smith because he's going to get confused.
Well, I got confused because I came in and you weren't here and then you came in after me. I came in between you and Trot.
Yeah.
How does that happen?
Oh, yeah, good point. Maybe we talked about it yesterday.
No, I was upstairs.
I'm confused.
And I walked in after.
That'll be it.
Yeah.
Oh,
there
weird.
We go.
So there we go. We solved
the riddle.
Great
there.
Mystery of the.
So, back to the Hat Chat.
I was thinking aliens.
Aliens, of course you were. If only you take your hat, take your hat off and do the aliens thing. Go on.
What's the hat alien thing?
No, take your hat off and then
just like,
your
put
face
your hands
looks
out
like it
just
doesn't want you to
put
your hair.
Aliens.
What?
Like the documentary.
Nah, because I'm being part of Hat Films. And, no, I can't even keep this hat on. It's so hot.
Nice.
I'll pull it off.
And do the aliens thing.
Do the aliens thing.
Go on. Fan service.
Aliens.
Mostly for Ross.
That's it. Gift.
I'm never going to see that.
Gift. It's been gift now.
I hope it's good.
Okay.
All right. So anything that can happen in Hat Chat, it could be something that we've got up to this week. It could be something that's happened in the news that we think is worth talking about. It could be stupid childhood memories that we've had that we've remembered suddenly.
What's
in a
more
dream.
Important is not to overthink it.
Yeah. It's just going to be a random section we
is
chat
that right, Trot?
For a bit in the Hat Chat.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Trot. So also, as per usual, we're going to take questions at the end from the live section of this podcast. So if you're tuning in live right now, you can tweet us, and that's the only place we're going to get the questions from is Twitter. So make sure you include the hashtag HatChat, and we'll pick it up and get
include
some questions
it.
At the end.
Include it in.
Include it. All
please,
right, sweet. So without...
For the love of God.
Is anyone up for the scrotum thing now? You've had a chance to think.
Well, three ball in it.
Yeah.
Three ball in it sounds ridiculous.
You've never heard of that before. I mean,
no,
you're from
what,
Swindon.
What
you've
does that
never
mean,
heard
though?
Of three
home
ball.
Of the three ball.
Homer's the three-bottom thing doesn't make any sense.
You put... All right. So imagine a scrotum with two balls. Two nice, rigid, round balls.
Rock solid.
And then you tuck your penis, you roll it up, keep rolling, because it's huge.
No.
In my case.
No.
And you put it between the two
balls.
And then it looks
no!
like a third ball.
Oh, God. It's magical.
Are you with me, Ross?
I'm with you.
It doesn't sound right.
Smithson.
I'd like to be in on that.
Right.
Doesn't sound right.
All right, well, fuck it. Me and Swiss will do it, and you can watch us. Let's go to the Hat Chat section.
To the Hat Chat section!
A new one.
Nice. Oh, there is no sound because
there was
the
a
way we set up the audio.
Smith noise.
Yeah, there's a little Smith noise, but that's not the noise.
Wait, the Hat Chat section.
Okay. Yeah.
We're in it now, though.
This is
so
it.
So there's two things in the Hat Chat section currently on the document.
I put something in.
One random. Of which is Pokemon TCG.
Trading card game.
Yep. And the other one is Geckos. Smith Geckos.
Yeah.
Fuck. He looks so fucking pissed off about it.
I mean, it's your gecko. Smith I thought you were
geckos.
Excited about your own gecko.
I'm really
excited
about my
geckos. You don't
stop
tweeting about it, so fucking talk about it then.
Can look, unfollow me if you don't like it, alright?
I want you to chat about your geckos.
Alright.
Why have you got geckos?
I've got some geckos now.
Why?
Because I like them. I've always wanted one as a child, so I got two.
Why did you get two?
Well, because I got one, and I thought it was a male.
You want them to shag, don't you?
Eventually.
You're trying to
well, obviously, if you remember from previous episodes of Hat Chat, we did the Russian space sex satellite gecko thing.
Yeah.
And that inspired me.
That
reignited my love and interest in geckos and lizards. I've always been a big reptile fan. Yeah. And I've never had the privilege of owning one or, you know, helping one through life as I see it. You can't own an animal. They own you.
What?
I'm actually a servant to the geckos now.
Wow. The lizard overlords.
Yeah, but I bought a really, really nice one, really pretty.
Yeah.
And I call it Kanye West. And
fancy.
Then because in the shop they work out whether it's a boy or a girl or whatever, or you know whatever the gecko
they
identifies
get it wrong,
as. And yeah, they got it wrong because as it grows up, the gender becomes more obvious, and it's become very obvious.
That's
now.
That's definitely a penis, guys.
Yeah. Well, no, they don't even have that. They just have little glands and little balls. They have little bulges for balls.
So how do geckos have sex, Alex?
I don't actually know.
Break it.
I don't
fully
know.
Down.
Let us know.
I don't know. I think they rub
sex.
Together. I
they
think
just
they must rub together, their
until
bellies.
Something happens.
So yeah, and anyway, so now Kanye is now Kim, and then I went in the shop the other day, and I'm like, oh my god, that's a really nice gecko you've got there. And they're like, yeah, it's a boy. And I'm like, oh cool, well mine's now a girl, so how about we get them together and go like that. But
I really hope they made that noise.
Yeah. But
really
then they're
do.
All good and they're all fine and they're living loving life. They got them out the other day, they did went on a little adventure together. Who knows where their life will go. I mean, they live for like 20 fucking years, so I'm gonna be
do
46
they?
Before they
you're gonna be so bored
they pop
of geckos.
Their I'm gonna be bored of geckos nearing my 50s,
but
I'm gonna have the same too.
You're gonna try and like breed them though, right?
Yeah, so yeah, you can just breed them and it makes lots of different patterns. There's millions of different pattern variations you can get.
You've got to collect them all.
You've got to catch them all. Pokemon.
But it's an infinite fractal-based system where there's infinite patterns, so you can't technically collect them all, so you will die trying.
Yeah, exactly. As a very old man with a lot of very old geckos.
I've almost got all the patterns. Just keep banging everybody. He's got a full room of banging geckos.
It's just like deafening. You go in there and it's like a
what sounds
it's like
they
a
make?
Factory floor.
That sound.
No, the only noise I've ever heard them make is like they make this weird like noise.
Can we get that again into the mic?
Like they do it like they, when they open their mouth and like sort of pretend to bite you, but because they're geckos and they've got no teeth and they're like the least threatening animals in the world, they do it to sort of like shock you, so you go ooh, and then they run off really quickly. They're quite quick. literally the noise they make, so they'll go if they're getting scared or something, they'll go and
sounds like they're choking.
It's weird noise. It did shock me the first time, and now they do it all the time. Well, not all the time. Now they do it every so often. They're just like, yeah come here, and they're like, oh shit, you weren't fooled. Because they're like,
oh,
they look
shit,
a lot more
fooled.
Skittish than like they really are. Like, you know, like I was really careful with them to start with. Like,
they have
oh.
to like just literally forcibly pick them up.
Yeah,
them.
Once you pick them up and like they go, oh, this isn't so bad. It's just the initial.
I'm all right.
They don't think like things looming over them. I guess it's like a predator response. Like, you know, if they feel like something's above them, they're like, oh, don't like that. But if you get down to their level and pick them up and look at them and stuff, they'll quite happily sit on you and wander about.
You should get a
weirdo.
You know what they do on like some people have like kitten shelters and stuff, where they constantly take in and raise litters of kittens and have a constant live stream.
Yeah.
You should have, like, gecko bang cam, so you can always tune in to potential banging of your geckos.
Yeah. Well, no, I think it'd be cool. And you have to get incubators and stuff. It's quite tricky.
And then we can have, like, a whole, like, paying system.
Yeah.
Where you can close the curtains and have a private sesh with them.
With the geckos.
And request stuff. You know, what, like,
but they're geckos.
Kinky stuff.
Well, they're geckos.
But you know, you can
see. Seems like
to,
an odd thing to. What? Actually, can you make them some little hats?
Huh?
Can you make the geckos some?
Yeah,
little
well,
hats?
Like I know their birthdays, so like, next time it's their birthday, I'll get them a little cone hat. I mean, they would literally
give them
hate
a special
that
day.
Shit.
Just
you're gonna cosplay
with
them.
I'd love to. And then as they grow up, they get less skittish. Like my friends, I've held his before, and they were like really grown up, and they're just chilled, and they just want to wander around. But these guys are still a bit like, oh fuck, I'm a teenager.
How far can you go with the dressing up thing? Sorry, that's taking my interest now.
I want to get little dragon wings and stick them on their back.
Can you like put a t-shirt on them? Like, can you cover their bodies?
I think they might.
That seems like a lot of effort. Like in terms of they're going to be wriggling and.
Can you put a bell
also
on
it? Also, they're
tail.
Quite delicate, aren't they? They're not exactly like, you're not going to just start pulling things onto them.
I heard if you pull its head off, though,
desert,
it'll just grow a new
I mean,
one.
They're delicate enough to survive a desert and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. No, I think you could put a t-shirt on them, but they I
want to see a gecko
t-shirt. Skins,
yeah,
you know,
you
I'm guessing they perspire.
Why not? Yeah,
so
like, let's put a t-shirt on small lizards. What? What is this?
Yeah.
What are we talking about here?
I mean, I do it
gecko cosplay, clearly. It's important.
Anyway, well, that's the geckos. Now segueing on to the Pokemon trading card game.
Yeah, because there are lizard types of Pokemon.
Yeah.
Like Bulbasaur.
Nice.
And I don't know others. But yeah, fuck me. Mm-hmm. It's really taken the office by storm. You probably know if you
not
follow.
Not more recently.
Not more recently. It's
more
filtering
recently,
off
it's
now.
It's actually kind of been no one.
But I think it's worth talking about because between hat chats, this happened.
It burnt bright.
It burnt bright for
within
a while.
A month, yeah.
The brightest star. And we were getting constant people from the
and
world.
And that was because
it.
Of the video, though. We made the video
most, yeah.
originally.
We mocked the idea of pack opening.
And then we're like, shit,
cards.
I really want some Pokemon cards, guys.
Yeah.
And then we genuinely.
Yeah, but that was mocking like the whole kind of revolution
the videos
of
them,
FIFA
yeah.
pack openers. And there's pack openings of all sorts of stuff now. Like Counter-Strike Go has like
oh,
crate
boxes,
openings
yeah.
and stuff. And
yeah,
like
Call of Duty has that stuff as well.
Some people are doing Hearthstone openings and like even down to like. Have you played Advanced Warfare where you open those shitty
yeah.
kind of crates? You don't really. Supply that's not
drops.
Really worth doing that on, but some people are doing it on that.
Are there like rare so things though? Like,
well, it's just like guns have slight differences.
Not enough to kind of be that excited about.
But yeah, then
but
they ham it up, don't they? I
well,
mean,
yeah.
ours is
well,
completely
yeah, I
authentic.
Know it's
isn't a lot of the stuff in Call of Duty just shit and like exactly the same
yeah.
as what you
normally
use?
No, yeah, exactly.
Oh my god! It's
what's the difference between what when you get a super rare gun in Call of Duty? Like, what happens?
All it is just the spec differences. If it's got like better damage, it's going to be. Slower to use and just it's just, you know
oh so they always
the,
balance it there's
yeah
no, like,
the improvement
overpowered
is
weapons.
Then you know written off by the fact that it's got a downfall so
that
it's
sounds
just,
shit
it's not really like oh yeah amazing
that sounds
it's just
shit.
Kind of yeah it's part of the game
trivial
yeah plus obviously you're not buying packs so like there's no real risk to it you're just playing
yeah.
a game you get a few packs so
so exciting
but yeah I mean our video went down quite well, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
we. I mean,
it was good.
It was going around the office where they were like, "Oh yeah, you should do a load of them," and we're like, "Well,
nah."
I think that would kind of ruin a lot of kind of what that whole point of that video was. Yeah.
It has to be a really good thing, I think. It couldn't be the same thing again.
Mm-hmm.
It would
yeah.
have to be like another like, oh, we can do a one-off like crazy reaction style thing, but it wouldn't be Pokemon again. Because
yeah.
just can't, physically can't react to that.
It's
yeah.
shiny.
A Bidoof again.
And then you
well, yeah, exactly.
You're...
Especially after we've actually got cards and stuff. And it's
did
just
you guys
like, oh.
see someone linked us the brown pack today?
Oh, the Bidoof one.
Yeah, it's just all Bidoof.
Yeah.
Like brown edition, Pokemon
your
brown edition.
Pokemon's Bidoof.
Everyone's Bidoof.
Gym leaders are all Bidoof.
Pretty funny.
Bidoof.
Fuck you.
Bidoof. But yeah, we got loads and loads of cards. We all got folders and stuff to put them in.
Mm-hmm.
We've even battled a lot with the yeah. cards. And we're still doing that, actually.
Stopped you a couple times, didn't I, Trot?
Hannah got a
well,
lot of cards.
Don't, we don't need to go into the details of the wins and
got
losses.
Four Charizards in my deck.
He's four. Got four Charizard EXs, I might add.
Including
he's
a Mega Evolution.
All shinies in his deck. His
yeah.
big deck.
Pay to
his
win.
Huge deck.
Pay to win, ladies and gentlemen.
Shiny deck.
Pay to win.
It's pay to win, essentially. But yeah, it's good fun.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm playing the shit out of the DS game.
Okay.
Which is gaming. See? It's still in a section. I'm playing the shit out of that, and I want to yeah. collect them all, and I have a problem.
Mm-hmm.
You do have
I need
problem,
help.
Mate. It's all right. Everyone has their vices
so,
and so forth. Somebody just asked us what our plan would be in a zombie apocalypse. So if it's suddenly, like, there's an outbreak right now.
Did they actually, or did you just pull that
no,
out of
No, someone
ass?
Literally just did and on Twitter, yeah.
Oh.
And I just figured, I don't actually have their name because it literally flicked past very quickly.
Okay.
But that's actually quite a curious question. I know Smith, you would be... quite into
I think Smith would be good to be around.
Why?
Because of your TA training.
I don't I've not been in the TA
because your airsoft training
Because you're trained in,
I've never
in
been
TA.
Trained.
You're military training.
I'm just one guy who's wandered around a wood for an excessive amount
but
of time.
But it's sort of like
but
teaching
you're,
yourself
you're
an
more,
instrument.
More trained than anyone else who hasn't been wandering around a
yeah.
woods with heavy
in
things
my
things
ability
on them.
To walk around a wood.
Yeah.
Not so, many people walk around wood, Smith, especially in shit weather and cold. And know how to.
Well, I have the right. I have a lot of gear.
Yeah, he's got the gear.
Plan. So, if you wanted to escape the city, for right. example, what would you do? Like right now. So it's happening right now.
Fucking hell.
During the podcast, I'm like, oh fuck, like shit. Like, what do we
do? 50% of Bristol.
I'd try and get over to Pret, and I'd try and find out how what salvageable food they've got.
So you're right. You're right.
I take it upstairs.
You're pillaging.
I barricade the stairwell because there's two floors.
Nice.
Okay. I barricade the stairwell, and
these
try
are,
and
these are gonna be fast zombies.
Yeah, well, we got to try and get some... Like, right now, yeah, the problem is right now. Where we are right now,
right
yeah?
Right now, fuck!
We've got zero food. We have some water. It's a fairly defendable position. Like, we've got these bars on the walls
we're
and
low,
shit
though.
Like that.
Thing is,
we're
like,
underground.
Exactly.
Yeah. We're going to be the
exactly.
first to go.
All the zombies are fucking piled down. We're in the basement of Yogg Towers. They'll fall down into the basement sort of window area. And eventually just sheer weight of bodies will push through these windows.
Yeah. Oh, my
so
God.
That's why I want to get upstairs in Pret, because it's relatively close to us. It's got food. It's got a staircase that we can easily
freshly
defend.
Made today.
But what if those... Because obviously that's a busy road. And obviously roundabout now, it's going to be busy as fuck. So if they're all like... All those cars are...
I reckon all
the
cars
can
be piled up.
Like, people are being smashed out of the cars.
Yeah.
Like, you can't cross that road, mate.
Yeah, okay. All right. Well, we'll just have to fucking hold up here then. Going outside's stupid.
Okay.
Yeah, guys.
So sticking it out. Yeah. Getting to the roof. Getting to the rooftops. And
luckily, we've
on.
Got a couple of guns with us. So if it calms down outside, we can go outside and use replica weapons to intimidate other people into giving us supplies.
Okay.
That would be my next thing. And I'd take
intimidating that. Other humans that are surviving.
Yeah. Well, I know. You try and work with them first. But let's be honest, most people
shoot
will,
them down.
Well, I mean, we're in St. Paul's, so there might be some people with real guns, which could be an issue.
At what point do we eat other humans?
Like late, because it's just going to make you really ill.
I reckon
Ill.
We should get straight into it.
Straight
make you
to
Ill
it.
As
I mean,
shit.
There's still food,
acquire a taste.
Plentiful sources
nah.
of food right now. Like,
yeah, but you know the future.
You think day one? Day one is the cannibals.
No, I would definitely try and stay down here for a few days. Like, definitely, because you want to try and wait for some of it to just play out. Then you.
I get to the roof. Or at least the top floor.
People say
I take everything, all the supplies and stuff, all the drinks that we got down here.
Yeah.
Take them upstairs.
Yeah.
Sniper
then,
tower.
Thing is, though, when you say, do you mean on the roof? Because you're gonna fucking freeze up.
No,
there.
Not on the roof. Like to the top floor, and we'll have access to the roof. Try and get access to the roof so we can look and kind of scope about. I think that would be the best kind of form. I mean, actually escaping though, maybe we could form some sort of, I don't know, zip line from the roof to another roof. Maybe in the style of Spider-Man.
You say this. I was thinking about this the other day. Like,
how would we set up a zip line?
I live on.
Well, there
like,
are already like electrical cables and stuff. We can maybe utilize
use
those.
Electrical cables.
Yeah, really go risk
Ross,
with it.
You're going to die without any zombies.
Cut some of those cables down and start utilizing our own zip wire system.
Yeah, maybe we could stay in and play DayZ for a bit and like train.
Train up.
Training, yeah.
Live to win.
Well, everyone's seen that series. They know how shit we were, so...
Everyone's seen it.
Everyone.
But yeah, the
everybody.
Bad news is all of my gear is about an hour and a half away at my brother's house, so...
So we need to go there, really.
Yeah, but driving anywhere is going to be a
driving,
fucking
you
nightmare,
can't drive
isn't
anywhere.
It? Off-road it.
Not on these roads.
You've got an estate car.
Yeah,
that's not,
fine.
An estate car's not an off-road vehicle, Jim.
Nah.
Especially
but
not
any car is
rear-wheel
an off-road
drive,
car,
sportline one. I've got the Land Rover... With like you know that motherfucker.
Yeah, again, that's again an hour
space.
And a half away.
Yeah,
I think you need to bring these things closer because the impending
wants me to,
zombie apocalypse.
Trot wants me to plan for the zombie apocalypse.
Yes,
I think
he wants you. He wants you to be like what's that TV show? There's a TV show.
Preppers.
Preppers.
Doomsday Preppers.
Doomsday Preppers.
Yeah, I know.
It's
well,
like that, isn't it?
I examine their plans and think, well, it's pretty solid. I think if I'm ever super rich, I will definitely set up a Doomsday bunker.
Well, we all know that there's
creating a bunker wouldn't be a bad idea, would it?
Oh well,
like a defensible
take
a
while.
Here's a subway. Segway.
Segway.
The word I was looking for is segway. Bunkers. Bombings. So the Russians have been sending...
Bunkers.
Bombings.
Russians
word
have
association.
Been sending fucking bombers down the middle of our
that's worrying,
like territory recently.
They technically... No, they didn't enter UK air.
Yeah, but they still flew down the English Channel.
Yeah, they're definitely swaying their muscles.
Like, in all seriousness, right...
If they start a war right now, that's maybe
we
that's
would
another
be really fucked.
Maybe that's another angle to go down in terms of. So if they started war now,
yeah.
In terms of you know they start you know attacking all the local countries.
Would you
around
be a conscript?
Them, like
yeah, I would. Yeah,
would you?
Yeah,
you go and fight the Russians.
I wouldn't
honest,
want
I think,
to fight.
I feel like
the
they
Russians.
Would probably enforce some of it, wouldn't they?
What depends. We've got a lot of armed forces to start with.
Yeah, what stage would it get to before they start?
Well, if it was a world war, then yeah, conscription would definitely be a thing. Not conscription, whatever they called it, voluntary signing up. Like, well, the thing is, like, obviously nobody wants to fight anybody, and also you'd hope that there are plenty of other like-minded individuals like yourself in Russia that don't want a war. It's just there's some crazy leaders there. I mean, we have crazy leaders as well. They're just not quite as crazy.
Mm. Could all happen.
But it kind of sucks. It would suck. Fuck. I mean, yeah. Like, Russia would be
I was saying to Trot again this morning, like that is, like, if they wanted to, they could really do some damage.
Oh, absolutely.
With this tiny little island.
Well, it's another thing, like, you know, World War II was basically stopped by nuclear armament. Like, you know, it's like, right, we've got these bombs, boom, boom, there you go, Japan, we've got these bad boys, do you want to give up now? Like, yes, please. Like yes. And that was really was... the last time that equally powered nations ever had to fight each other. You know, right now we are always fighting these wars with, like, farmers, basically, who don't have any of these capabilities. And, like, it'd be pretty scary, really, to go up against a nation like Russia and probably China would ally with them as well. And yeah.
We could do propaganda on YouTube.
Yeah, it'd be terrible. So? Well, mate, the thing is, though, like, say
we could do propaganda.
Say those bombers did fly down.
Let's rally the troops.
We identified they had nuclear warheads on board, because those bombers that flew down could definitely carry nuclear armament. Mm-hmm. You know, we could be at war next week. We really could.
Are you up for it?
Well, like, it'd be terrifying. Up imagine that.
I think you are literally kind of, yeah, it's, you know...
Everybody, we're so used to just living a life with no memory of war. Our parents have never really known war.
Well,
you
there's
know,
no memory of war, because there generally wasn't one.
No, but I mean, like, you know, your grandparents probably, were born around World War II time.
Of course.
But yeah, and it's like, it's terrifying, really.
Yeah, but there's little we can do to prepare, like, ourselves, us.
Yeah.
So what do you feel like we should change in our
lifestyles? Nothing. We can't change it.
I think it's important for...
Do you think
we need to
learn hand-to-hand combat, Trump?
Hand-to-hand combat.
Against a nuke. just falling down.
In case the troops come down.
We can punch the radiation away.
I feel like nuke won't be the first response, because that's...
Maybe,
you know,
chemical warfare.
The world, but.
Yeah, you say that, but, like, how would it start then? Like, what, like, so, oh, we've shelled you. Okay, we'll shell you back. Like,
well, it would start like that, wouldn't it? Yeah.
No, because
I don't think they would, the nuke would be so rushed into.
You say that, but think about this, right? So, say Russia attacks us with bombers, let's say. So they bomb London, they bomb five of our major cities. Trident subs, the entire reason we have Trident subs, nobody knows where they are apart from us, obviously. Our Trident nuclear missiles are bobbing around the sea somewhere.
We'll
respond with...
They're going up and down the lake.
Oh, there it is, in Weymouth. They will respond with, stop shooting us, stop bombing our cities, we're going to nuke you, right?
Yeah.
And they'll either go, okay, we'll stop, or no, we won't, and then we'll nuke them. So they know that. So any nation with nuclear capabilities would know that. So they would have to be, I would imagine, a preemptive nuclear strike. So you could take out all major command infrastructure.
That's scary. It's scary. Straight to nukes.
Preemptive strike.
I don't know. It's kind of scary. I don't know enough about this shit. I'm just some guy on the internet playing computer games. But it's an interesting. I mean, it's a bit of. I don't know whether we should talk about it. Really, it's a bit of a scary downer. I like talking about it a lot.
Well, but it's so far detached from reality for us.
It is right now. Yeah,
we can't.
Might not be.
Like, there's little we can plan or even predict what would happen, because it's all under wraps.
But would we still play games on YouTube?
Yeah, probably from our bunker.
Yeah, what
from the
bunker?
From our bunker.
Well, just think of all the noise that, like, in the background.
We could play Fallout 3, guys.
The noise would be annoying.
Just the gunfire going.
All
off,
the Fallout games. What if the Russian?
Okay, guys, today we're going to do a themed game.
Ironically, we're going to play Fallout.
What if the Russian bombers was just a publicity stunt by Bethesda to get Fallout?
It's just huge PR budget. Well, we sent the jets, sorry.
Well, look what North Korea did to that film. I mean, they've, you know, boosted the interview.
Maybe that was
way
all
more
part
than
of the plan.
Maybe, yeah. They said, yeah, listen, we'll give you some, you know, a bit of cash if you promote it. Get all angry, ban it, and then, yeah.
Fucking
and
hell.
That's a success.
I feel like shit now.
What? Thinking about nuclear
destruction? Brink of war. And
are we at the brink?
Well, Smith said it's going to happen next week.
Oh, for Christ's
I didn't
sake.
Say it was going to happen next week. I said it could.
Is it happening next week, Smith? Let us know.
I haven't got enough time,
you know,
for this.
Yeah.
What else has happened recently that has taken my?
If you
notice?
Had time, though, what's the first thing you would do? Like, if you said, okay, well, in 2 days,
I'd probably shit myself for one. I continue to shit myself. Maybe pass out from not breathing properly.
Would you visit loved ones, or you just...
Well, it depends what's happening.
Christ, this is so depressing.
In this situation,
what's
happening?
Just tell me the truth, Chuck.
What, if a nuke's coming?
Yeah.
Well, then you'd have about, I don't know, an hour, maybe two, before it happened.
Okay.
If we had long range guidance, like long range tracking of it, which we might not, because the Russians might have developed stealth technology for their missiles.
But what if that wasn't the first attack? And it's like there's a small attack. It's like, oh.
What? So they blew up Bognor Regis?
Yeah.
So you're saying
chip off bits of the island?
I'd be like, fucking hell! Good job they got rid of Bognor Regis. That place was a dump.
Then next target, Bristol. What do we do?
Get out of Bristol. Get the hell out of Dodge.
There's way too much entertainment industry in Bristol. It's far too much of a threat.
Do you think we should learn how to fly vehicles like helicopters, and then
we should probably start pretty soon.
I'd say a boat is a better option for you than an aircraft.
We can get out of the Bristol Canal.
Yeah, partially because it's a lot easier to get access to boats.
Those what are they called?
Canal barges.
Barge. Get a cheeky barge.
What, the aren't seaworthy at all?
I reckon we should
get a cheeky barge.
No, let's hear him out. Hear him out, Smith.
Yeah, we'll get a cheeky barge. Row it as far as we can out to sea.
It's got
to
be really
cheap. You don't row a barge, they weigh a fuck ton.
Yeah, we're going to go all the way out to sea with it.
There's no draft. They've got short drafts, meaning that they'll roll over in the sea.
Yeah, but there are beds.
Ross Hornby drowned again.
Ross
Hornby dies of electrocution.
So firstly,
Ross Hornby drowns.
Yeah, but those things have beds in them. And cook. And you can cook.
Why not just get a proper sailboat and go anywhere?
Ross needs a good fucking sleep, all right?
Yeah.
He needs a bed.
And to be slow and steady.
You can't get that in any other
place. Slow and steady, we'll go. That's what we'll do. Let's get a barge.
Makeshift raft.
You want a makeshift raft?
Yeah, I reckon we should go closest island.
Either way, we aren't equipped for any of this stuff.
I once made made a raft with some people that won a raft race, which was three industrial sized rolls of bubble wrap.
Nice.
On an axle attached to like a pallet with barrels underneath it. Okay. And it allowed us to pick the front of the pallet section up and roll it on the big rolls of bubble wrap.
That's
roll
amazing.
It into the sea, sit on it, and off we went down the river.
Think of all the little tiny air pockets of bubble wrap. It's just so buoyant.
Yeah, and you could use weapons to fight each other, right? So weapons. We did it in this town called Dartmouth, and they have loads of pubs there, and the pubs make a raft every year. But they always do things like they'll get, you know, those things that you pump and spray for like spraying plants and stuff.
Yeah.
So you pump it up, and then you can spray them with like fertilizer. They'd fill those with like pickled egg juice and stuff like that, and they'd spray you with it if you got too close. But I had like a ridiculously big super soaker that shot like a pint a second of water, and they'd get too close and I'd fire it at them and just like knock them off, and then we started filling bags with flour and water and using one of those wild slings at like 10 feet. It's pretty good.
The other good thing about a bubble wrap raft is not only is it extremely buoyant,
yeah,
you also get the pleasure of popping the top surface.
Yeah, but you slowly sink.
Oh.
Yeah, but it'd be funny on the way down.
It'd be quite hilarious, yeah. Wouldn't it?
It'd be such a good laugh.
I don't know who that'd be hilarious for.
Who?
The people. It wouldn't be hilarious for anyone.
No, it wouldn't. We'd all lose.
It's actually quite devastating.
And drown.
Guys, you'd be like an iPhone because you're sinking.
Oh, good one.
What?
Or bending. Am
or
I right?
Bending if you're Ross Hornby's iPhone, which is bent.
It's not completely bent. It's just very slightly bent.
So, with all this depressing talk about nuclear...
Whoa, I tried to lighten it up with some bubble bath.
I don't mean to skirt
and
over that.
Go on.
Importantly, if you do start to talk about it, make sure to call it nuclear and not nuclear.
Yeah, right.
Nuclear.
Just
nuclear.
Yeah.
Nuclear.
Also, if the nuke is coming towards us, remember to get under a desk and put your head between your legs.
And have a good... autofillate.
No, there was
that's
whole,
all you're gonna
there
do.
There was a whole campaign during like the 50s and 60s where, well, yeah. 60s, sorry, where they're just like, oh, you know, duck and cover. It's like, it wouldn't do anything at all.
Easier to clean.
In
it,
case
easier,
of the
it
nuke,
is easier to clean. That's true.
Stop, drop, and roll. And autofillate.
And autofillate.
Well, let's just hope that doesn't happen. Okay.
Well,
let's just hope. Fingers crossed, guys.
Let's
fingers
talk about
crossed.
Real
it's almost
shit.
Easter. Let's enjoy some mini eggs. And
everybody
not,
make
not
a wish.
Everyone make a wish.
Hope for no nukes.
Mm-hmm.
And let's talk about real news that's actually happened that's hilarious, am I right?
Oh, well, you mean funny news?
Yes.
Oh, well, that sounds like a
swiftly
really
move on
good...
to that.
Okay, let's do that then, Trot.
Right, Ross, are you going to join in this time with the whole scrotum three ball?
I really don't feel comfortable about that, Trot.
Is it because your wiener's too small?
Such a tiny wiener.
If anything, wouldn't that help because you want it to just tuck in?
Yeah.
Why is your wiener so small?
Yeah. Talk about that, Ross. Why is it so
it's
absolutely
a tactical
tiny?
Decision.
Everybody
it's
in
a
the
tactical
chat
decision.
Saying that I'm a Russian spy now.
You could well be. You could well be, mate.
Everyone's
Why?
Now saying I'm a Russian spy.
Are you?
How
a
long
Russian
have you known
spy?
Me?
Why would you be a Russian spy?
I've been watching Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. recently, and I don't want to spoil anything.
Is
that the one
me,
that looks kind of like a...
You've known me to exist since I was 14, so...
Well, you're a pretty fucking good one, is what I'm saying. Or you killed a guy, took his facial, you know...
Face.
You know, like Mission Impossible.
His facial
face. Or you're 40
face.
Years older than you say you are, and you actually are.
You've implanted the memories of us being friends in my brain.
That is possible.
Using Russian technology that we don't know about.
Really advanced Russian technology that somehow still
saying
runs
that,
on Steam.
I do forget a lot of things recently and in the past.
I'm forgetting a lot recently. I reckon that's
some
Smith.
Sort of like technology.
That's a byproduct of all the crazy cocaine parties we're having.
See, I don't know if those
I don't remember those.
Don't worry, I'll put the memory in your legs.
Extra chips.
The only thing I'll be putting in your legs. Ooh!
Dirty!
Yay! Right, okay. Really excited. Let's do the next stage where I'm not a spy anymore.
All right, let's ball, tuck, and roll.
Ball, tuck, and roll!
Maybe I'm the spy. And maybe I'm double bluffing.
Maybe
anyway.
Time for some
funny
news. Oh my god, it's so funny.
It's so hilarious, I don't even know what to talk about.
Just gotta load the... Here we go. You ready?
Go on.
I've got one.
Okay.
It's not that funny. St. Louis punk band raising money to have its own drummer killed.
That's so like them.
That's so out there.
St. Louis.
Why?
St. Louis' long-running gigs of shock punk without motherfucking order, that's their name, without motherfucking order,
right.
Or WMFO for short, mm-hmm. have started a new crowdfunding campaign. This is how to do a Kickstarter, guys. To have the band's drummer Crash killed.
Right.
With a goal of only $100. That's it. $100 and it's done.
Right.
It actually seems like one of the more fiscally feasible efforts of its kind. And from the GoFundMe page, it says, Crash has gotten so old that we at Without Motherfucking Order Industries have decided it's best he be euthanized. Jesus. We've waited 16 years for him to die of old age, but recently discovered that he's a Highlander, much like Connor McLeod, and the only way he can die is by decapitation.
How old is he?
I don't know, but...
I give him an age.
See, I hear you read things like this, and it's just like, look, I say the same thing I said to Area 11. Just keep writing good music and drop all the shitty gimmicks.
Wow. Holy shit.
No, I'm joking. But no.
This is good PR, though, because...
No, I'm joking. They don't write good music.
Wow.
Shit.
Scathing.
Sparkles will be on the blow.
I'm related to Sparkles. It's fine.
Both.
Everyone will believe that.
I just say anything I like here. I'm a Russian spy.
He'll implant memories to make us believe him because we're friends for life. Yeah. But yeah, they've done a drawing of the death machine they're going to kill the drummer with, and it seems like they want to remove his head with like a, you know, like the grabber machines in an arcade, where it's just sort of
well, the ones that don't grip anything.
Yeah, but this one's going to grip by the looks of the machine, and yeah, it grips on the head and then pulls the head off.
Jesus.
Above, you'll see a diagram of the death machine we need to make in order to accomplish our goal and to pay our super scientist Tex Johnson to finish the build and design. It seems as though Crash is immortal, having been part of the St. Louis band scene since at least the first incarnation of Very Metal in 1994.
Christ, I've got to stop you. I actually don't know what the story is.
Well, I told you.
I've completely phased out.
Smith, did you understand
TLDR,
the story?
TLDR, give us a TLDR.
I wasn't actually listening.
Give
us
you
a
weren't.
Trot, give us a TLDR.
Is anyone listening? Is
give
anyone
me a
watching
fucking
right now?
TLDR, Trot. I don't know what's going
one
on.
One thing I would say, Trot, is move your pop shield up a little bit and try not to speak directly into your microphone.
There we go. Advice.
Yeah, because Trot? I'm just watching you back on the stream and you're really like.
It's because
really
I'm very
advice.
Animated about
like,
this.
Just move the shield
see,
over and speak over it rather than into it.
Tell us exactly what, in a short term,
what's happened
is.
It's very simple. It's a fucking shock punk band.
Okay, there's a shock punk band. Okay.
That have decided to make...
I just feel like you've gone too far into it at this point.
I'm TLDRing it, Smith!
Well, keep going.
That's
keep
a
going.
Fucking
TLDR.
Summary!
Don't make us... Go on.
So, they started a Kickstarter campaign.
Okay, Kickstarter campaign.
To kill him.
To kill...
Their drummer. Because he's
what?
Too old. That's it.
Okay.
That's the story.
That's ridiculous.
Laugh now!
Sorry.
Cue laughter. Funny.
Yeah, great. That was quality. Do you want to listen to mine?
No.
I found two stories where a mum kills their kid.
Oh, for God's sake.
Two? How is that so common?
Mm-hmm.
Jesus.
Right, cool. Well, I got one.
Sorry, that's not part of the funny news, Trot.
Let me
laugh.
Phase out for a second.
Yep.
Go on.
You've suitably phased out?
Yep.
Ghost
Smith. Well, you responded, so you're not phased out.
Ghost Smith.
Couple of leave all their cash to a pet monkey. Bresh and Shabista Srivastava say they owe their success to a primate that has enriched their lives. These people, when they die, are going to leave all of their wealth to a pet monkey.
Oh,
so there's this fucking monkey, right? What's he going to do with all this money?
Well, he can't spend it.
He doesn't know how to spend it. He doesn't understand the concept of cash.
A monkey won't be able to spend it. Sorry.
If you have another banana, please. Okay, so that'll be $400.
Is that a talking monkey?
Oh, fuck.
Holy shit.
Also, do you think someone's would be have the balls to rip off a monkey?
I don't know. Well, monkey might rip your balls off.
Well, exactly. That's what I mean. I mean,
in this article,
maybe it's in safe hands. Yeah.
This article has pictures of three different species of monkey. I don't understand
it's like
why.
A macaw.
It's hiding its identity. Clearly,
isn't that a parrot?
What's the
isn't it macaw? You thinking of marmoset? Sound it out. Macaw is a breed of parrot.
Yeah, it's macaw is a parrot, Ross.
I'm gonna have to fucking Google this now.
You're thinking of marmoset, I think, mate.
Marmoset.
Nice. So
monkeys.
When these guys die, the inheritance money is going to a monkey.
Yeah, it's quite, it's not great. Yeah. It's just stupid as shit. I just wanted to think about more. I wanted to try and play on the idea that.
Where's the punchline?
Well, it's just a monkey with a load of cash when they die.
You can imagine this.
According
big
to the
spending.
Pair, the monkey enjoys Chinese food, tea, and mango juice.
How much is he gonna get?
His name's Chun Mun.
Mandrill, Manga Bay, and Marmoset.
Yep.
Thanks,
Ross. I don't know which one I was thinking of.
Well, macaw. But
I was thinking
that's
of
a
fucking,
parrot.
I was thinking of a fucking
you were thinking
bird.
Of
a parrot.
Yeah.
Macaque!
Yeah. Chun Mun, his name is. So Chun fucking Mun. Chun Mun, wealthiest monkey in the village, munching down on bananas and.
Chinese.
Oh, I wonder if you could get hire him, like an escort or something, and they just get really weirded out.
No, I was thinking of a macaw.
For fuck's sakes, Ross.
A sorry, macaque? I was just still. Yeah, it's a monkey.
Macaw.
Macaque.
Macaw. Macaulay Culkin.
That's what I was thinking of.
Oh, okay.
I'm not completely stupid.
Macaque. Milady.
I think it's not pronounced macaque.
Macaque!
Maybe.
Macaque.
Either way, I just want to picture this monkey macaque. In a custom made tailored suit with tinted shades and a really nice hat because he's just got the money. He's swaying, he's got swagger, he's got a limo. It'd be amazing. And his own little theme park.
It's pronounced macaque.
Fucking hell, are you all just Googling now?
Yeah, yeah.
Jesus.
It was the monkey thing, for Christ's sake, Trot.
I had to the bottom of it. That was great. Thanks, Alex. Thanks.
thank yourself, you Russian spy.
Ah, Alexander. Hey.
Alexander.
It's a fucking Russian name.
Oleg.
Right, go then, Ross, bring it up,
mate. He hasn't got one.
Oh, okay, let's have a look. Okay, other than the there's so many stories about Fifty Shades of Grey and
Ross. God, yeah. We're gonna feed you certain words, and you have to form.
Sorry, there's one headline here: okay. Feral pack of Fifty Shades of Grey fans attack man in movie theater.
Feral pack.
let me read this one.
Yeah, let's go for that.
One I was gonna go with was CrossFit bodybuilders drinking breast milk for protein.
Oh God, so
I don't know which one to choose.
Holy
there's
shit.
So much to choose
so
from.
Much bearing fruit on this tree.
Let's see. Oh, God. I mean, this one, I mean, probably not the Fifty Shades one because it just goes on about kind of, I don't know, all sorts of stuff that there's no point in discussing right now to anger other people. So, let's see. As a new mum, Rebecca deals with a lot of odd questions from complete strangers, but a recent conversation in a grocery store topped them all. A gentleman walked up and asked if I was breastfeeding my daughter. Recalled Rebecca. It wasn't that question that started Rebecca, it's what the man said next.
Go on.
What did he say?
He lingered for a minute, and you could tell he was a little nervous to ask. And then he asked if I would be interested in selling him my breast milk, said Rebecca. I just sort of looked at him strangely and said, I don't think so, but if you need breast milk, they have milk banks for that. To make sure babies get milk, and he said, oh no, it's not for me. Oh no, it's for me. I'm doing bodybuilding and CrossFit. Christ, this article's really long.
Yeah.
But basically, long and short, guy wanted some breast milk, was asking random women
Was thirsty.
For this stuff. That's
why,
pretty
come
rude.
On,
would
there's
you
like
ask
so many
somebody?
Other things you can drink that's not other people's breast milk.
Like protein shake.
Yeah.
Has far more protein in it probably than breast milk.
Yeah, but did anyone stop to ask this man if he's just a weird pervert?
Probably he is.
Probably did.
Yeah.
Oh, and he also seemed to have a raging hard on.
I like that she responded. She went, oh no, by the way, there is actually a sensible answer. Not like, get away from me, you weirdo. Just, oh yeah, no, there is a nice place you can go. They're actually really friendly.
The thing is, though, if
actually, no, I just want to take it straight from your tits, please. What? No, you're a weirdo. Back off.
Nice.
That is weird.
Cool. God.
Would you ever ask anyone that?
Yeah, I have several times. In fact, that was me.
I have several times. That was you and
that was
Rebecca.
Me.
That was the Rebecca.
I just want to get better at CrossFit.
Previous
so
ones.
You keep saying Rebecca, and all I can think is Friday.
Rebecca.
That's all you can think of.
Is that true?
It's Friday.
My alter ego is Rebecca. Don't forget.
Okay.
Right.
So, yeah, it was.
Did any of you see Afro Man punch a fan the other day?
Yeah, fucking hell. That
he
was
he really fucking lamped
Who's
her as
Afro
well.
Man?
Afro Man, you know, he made a couple of songs. Because
they got high. Oh, that guy, yeah. Yeah,
yeah right. So
he
was like
fan.
Playing guitar or something.
Punched some woman on stage.
Some woman was like dancing like on like with her back to his. Pretty close. And then
so
he kind of lashed
invader.
Out and just slammed her, like. Slammed her really hard.
Really fucking hard.
As he spun around and she just fucking went down like a ton of bricks. It looked brutal. I'm guessing she's
Holy
okay.
Shit.
I don't know. But
fucking psycho. Like, it must have been annoying, I know, but he shouldn't, like, fuck me.
Get security or something.
Yeah, and
off.
Then the guy got up on stage, and you see, he sort of went, oh, you want to make something of it, bro? Like, to him, like, holy fuck, like, what an arsehole.
Just a whole chain of people getting pissed
Jesus
off
Christ.
With him knocking out people.
Yeah, I mean...
Anyway,
wow.
that's another downer subject, but yeah, that
right.
was stupid as
Sorry,
shit.
Sorry, I saw the article, and I thought, Jesus Christ, that was brutal.
Okay, Ross, actually, yeah. no, Smith. Mm-hmm. Because of the news, this section hasn't been fantastic. Mm. I like to blame myself for that.
I'd like to take full
okay,
We're
going
to
completely fabricate something now. So
Sorry?
Me and Ross are going to create two characters
okay.
and a scenario.
Okay.
And you're going to make up news.
Okay.
It's going to come out of fucking thin air.
Right. Why are we calling it news then?
Because it's news to me.
It's news.
It's not news. It's just
a new news.
They make up news all the time.
No news is bad news.
Okay.
On Fox News.
In the role of Fox News right now.
Like all of Birmingham.
Connor, just give them the roles. Let's do this.
Jesus Christ.
We got Julian.
Who's Julian?
He's a cello player.
Okay.
But his strings,
yep.
he uses for other means, which
right.
Ross is now going to explain
okay.
with the other character.
Julian uses the strings.
Cello strings.
The cello strings.
Yep.
Not to play the cello, but to hang off Christmas cards.
That's so incredibly tame and boring. There are so many things you could have done with that, and you decided that he hangs Christmas cards off things.
He lops off monkey dicks with his cello strings.
There
all right,
go.
Okay.
He lops off
and he makes necklaces dicks. Out of those said monkey dicks.
Okay,
and they call him the Monkey Dick King of Kingsbury.
Can he not dangle the Christmas cards off the monkey?
He can
dicks,
do that as well.
He does that.
Okay, so Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry
Bye.
Christmas.
Well, that was a fantastic story, I'd say.
Well, it's not. Is it over?
Well,
is that it?
Is there more to the
story? Jesus Christ, there should be inquiries and everything. Yeah. Why is he doing anything?
He's all right. He's not breaking the law, really.
Don't try and come onto the monkey dick king of Kingsbury's turf and
what?
Tell him where to hang his monkey dicks.
Right? He likes
Why,
to create...
Where is he getting all the monkeys? Where is he living?
He breeds
where are we,
them.
Madagascar?
He breeds them.
He breeds them
yeah,
so he can cut off their
basement.
Dicks.
So mm-hmm. he can cut off their dicks, and make a circle around him, a circle of truth and strength.
No dicks.
Sorry, does he kill the monkeys?
No.
Okay, so they've just
They just grow them back.
What? Sorry,
he's genetically modified the monkeys so they can grow their own dicks back.
That's
he mixed
story.
It with.
Let's, just,
incredible.
Let's go back
that's
into
incredible.
The backstory.
That's
let's
science.
Go to origin story.
That's
perhaps.
A that's a model.
No, no, no.
You know, a modern miracle.
No, it's a little tiny tagline on.
That's
the
a previous
site.
Part of the.
It's not important.
You didn't.
I mean, it's pretty
that's,
important.
That's
he's fundamentally
really
old.
Julian's far more important.
Primate
like,
DNA to regenerate penises. What happens if you don't cut that penis off? Is it like do they get ill if you don't?
No, they get extra big and they die because all the blood rushes to it.
So if anything, he's created a monster that he needs to.
He has to sustain the monkey. By cutting their dicks off to keep them alive. So if anything, he's a saviour and a saint
okay.
to these monkeys.
Poor monkeys.
He's done a Frankenstein thing, but it's all in...
Has he ever tried to build a monkey entirely out of dicks?
I think so.
Do
I'll ask
do
him.
That? Well, stitching them together to create... Like, it's a very like kind of human centipede style...
Dick monster.
Creation, yeah.
Wouldn't that be an amazing story, though, guys? Like,
what?
So,
like, amazing in what way?
Mad scientist...
Yeah.
Invents method of regrowing monkey dicks, mm-hmm. but is so psychotically insane that he has to keep lopping them off. And the caveat is the monkey will die if he doesn't do that.
Right. So and like there's a heart to heart where the monkey's talking to him. It's like, you gotta cut it off, Randy.
There's also got to be a problem. Every time he cuts it off, something happens to the monkey a little bit,
like
chips
them.
Away at them, so get more and more
so
psychotic.
Their soul.
And then eventually they eat him.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, right. So it's gone back to them now.
It's a circle of life.
I don't know how or why we got onto this.
Do you reckon we could get him on the phone?
No, I don't know. I don't know why this
Monkey Dick Man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Does anyone know Julian's number?
Huh?
Does anyone know Julian's number?
Who?
Julian.
K- King Julian.
The celloist who's turned mad scientist.
I don't know.
Monkey Dick Lopper.
Yeah, it's 0800 cello dick now.
Well, I'm ringing it now.
Okay.
Who's going to pick up?
Okay. Julian, that's a nice hopefully.
Phone. It's a new phone.
That's his ringtone.
Okay, Smith's got to answer, isn't it?
I thought you were the character.
Hello.
Julian? Julian.
Hi, mate.
Hello, mate.
How's it going?
How's it going? You alright?
Yeah, not too bad.
Oh, is that the monkey?
Oh, shut the fuck up!
How many dicks? Sorry. How many dicks this week?
How many dicks?
Yeah, you cop.
Well,
cop.
Like one.
One? Just the one?
Do you know how long it takes to make a monkey?
No.
Idiot. It takes ages.
Sorry, Julian. I didn't mean to offend
you. Do you think
you.
This isn't a factory here? This is a one-man machine.
Sounds pretty aggressive back there.
Yeah. Calm down! Heal over!
If you cut it off more than five times, you know what happens if you cut the dick off more than five times, Ross? Julian?
Yeah.
Ross, your assistant, sorry.
Yeah, go on.
I was just talking to him.
What happens? Well, you tell me, because I've done it 10 times.
10?
Yeah.
Well, shit.
Yeah?
Are you in a safe place?
I'm actually in a really dangerous place.
You know the monkey gets randier the more you lop
well,
his dick.
Well, I'm surrounded by angry, aggressive monkeys, exactly. So
which one is it? What's the name? It's
which
not...
one? Oh, it's Henry.
Oh, thank God. It's not Nancy.
No.
Because you know what Nancy's like.
Well, Nancy didn't have a dick.
Extremely randy, especially around
well,
you.
Well, Nancy didn't have a dick.
You're not wearing
hey,
the...
Hey, Julian, we got another monkey who needs his dick cutting off back
yeah,
here.
Okay, just use some string.
Is that your assistant?
Pull it really, really
he's
hard.
He's getting really angry.
Yeah, just use some... Use the cello wire.
He's on my face.
No, for Christ's sake.
Help. Are you still using cello strings?
Always. That's the best way. It's the
you
only
know
way.
That's weird, right?
That's
you know
the only
that's
way.
Weird. I mean, there's
no, the cello string is the best and only way. If you can find
a
better way,
then... I gave you a
jigsaw. Hey, whose necklace is this?
I'm not using a jigsaw, Trot. It's messy.
Julian?
Christ.
Julian, I got a necklace back here. It looks like a little dicks.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Is it a bad time
don't
to
eat it.
Is
it?
Oh.
Julian?
Yes?
Is it a bad
okay,
time
I'll
to
just
say
put
that?
It back down.
Is it? What's he saying? Is that your assistant? What's
yeah, happening? He's just... No, he's just cutting the dicks off.
Right. With me on the phone? It's a bit...
Oh, God.
No, it's a bit rude, isn't it? I mean,
so
I'm talking on the phone. I'm trying to do something. He's just...
Oh, the monkeys
the
hate
they're
having their dicks cut off. I'll tell you that for free.
Of course they do.
Why is he on the phone?
Why are you on the
Hello?
Fucking line?
Am I on speaker?
He's on the line.
Hello?
No, he's on the line as well. He always
How are you on
up.
The line?
Just,
he's rude.
Who's this?
It's Trot.
Who are you?
I'm a mate of Julian's. We go way back.
You're looking for a dick necklace?
Don't
no,
try and sell me
he's
shit.
He's not trying to buy them. He
don't
gave me the cello string.
Shit. We've got a whole spare room of this
well,
shit.
We need to shift some of these, Julian. I mean, we got like 400 monkeys in the
Did
basement.
Did you get someone from America?
He gave me the cello string. I don't know what to do about that. I mean... Listen, I'm going to shut up business because this is ridiculous.
You're selling stuff.
Yeah, what are we going to do with all these monkey dicks?
Of course I sell them.
You're
monkey
selling
dicks.
Monkey dicks.
Yeah.
What are we doing with all of them?
How
what
many
do you mean?
For like
put
five?
Them on a necklace,
How many
obviously.
For five?
How many for five? Five, yeah. What, dicks or necklaces?
Like a cigar box of them.
Cigar box.
Yeah.
That's a nice idea,
20
actually.
Grand.
20 grand.
20 grand.
Hey, man, the Chinese market loves it.
You're just trying to get all that money.
Yeah.
You've
seen what they do to dolphins, right?
You haven't set up inheritance
Same
again.
Same thing with monkeys. All the monkeys survive.
And they take their dicks.
They just take the dicks.
I'm hanging up on this shit. This is bullshit.
Yeah, no. Fair enough.
Well, all the dicks are for me.
All the dicks are for me.
My dicks now.
Christ.
You see, that would never, ever
That's
happen.
Not real, by the way. That's not real news.
No.
Julian doesn't exist.
That wasn't... the word news doesn't come into it at all.
No.
In any sense of the word.
We should make that the section called That's News to Me. Because
it's not
news. Real.
Sorry... That's not news to anyone. That's not news to you.
Well, that's an alternative.
That's
not news.
Factual information, that's news to me.
That's not news.
That's not news to me.
That's not news at all.
That's not news at all. It's the section.
That's the section. That's not news at all.
That's not news at all.
It's
the news.
Questionable section. It may not be a permanent feature.
Next week, time travel.
Oh, nice. That's not news to me.
That's not news
to me. That might be news to me.
It might be next week.
Should we move on to the live section?
Got the Q&A's lined up. We've already got a load of questions coming on in.
Oh, we have. Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Did you put these there?
So here's the live Q&A's. These were submitted via our Twitter at @hat_films and using the hashtag HatChat. We pulled them from our Twitter. So this is where these came from. If you want to contribute for a future podcast, just do that.
Podcastness.
Podcast.
All right, should we kick it off? So the first one is from
Sir the most enthusiastic
John
voice.
Snow. He says, how much or money she. Have you guys spent on Pokemon cards so far? I'd probably say about 100 quid.
I'd say you spent more than that.
I think...
You spent way more than that.
Yes. No. Well,
when we were
spent?
Halfway through
I
our addiction, you said, I've spent about 100 quid on this. And then you bought boxes since.
I can check my Amazon list.
Rather than saying specific amount, I think that you have spent the most, Smith.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's easy for everyone else, isn't it? Because then they can just go, well, not as much as Smith, and hide in their fucking denying.
I've bought almost as much.
It's the stuff that you bought online that was, yeah. That
okay, right. So
I
bought
extra stuff.
Well, no, the stuff I bought online. Okay, so I bought one Phantom Forces theme deck.
Yeah.
Value of £9. Stuff,
yeah.
One Pokemon trading card EX Power Trio tin, £13.
Yeah.
Pokemon Charizard box, £17.
Got this list already, instantly.
So Amazon.
Oh, he's got a list.
And then some three Pokemon Flash Fire boosters for about £9.
You've also bought a lot of boxes.
How much was that?
It's about, probably about £50 or £60 there.
There's okay. £60. And then from the shop.
But from the shop itself, I mean,
oh,
we've
yeah.
all been
oh,
there.
Yeah,
so
maybe
yeah.
And Tesco's.
Yeah, a couple of £100.
So it's starting to add up. It's starting to tally up.
Quite a lot.
It's getting to a point where it's almost embarrassing
too
to
much.
Say how much. So Smith has probably spent the most. So that's just.
But these guys have also probably spent
how much,
over £100.
Yeah, yeah.
I have no idea how much. But
we're not, we're not skirting spent, over the fact that we
I'm
have.
I'm pretty sure other people in the office have spent a lot more than you.
So
even then,
needless yeah. to say, when the new one, Phantom,
it's in
Force.
Triple figures all round.
Right? So that's the power of nostalgia.
The power of nostalgia.
Right. Cicella Winberg at Cicella Winberg says, "What's with the beards, guys?" Well, good question. Smith's always had a beard.
I don't know. Last Hat Chat, I only just started kind of having it, and I just didn't bother shaving it properly.
I've actually trimmed mine down more since everybody
yeah.
else's because I
yours
feel like
is
I need
nice
to balance
and,
it out
and clean and crisp, Smith, and it suits you. I've just gone for the whole don't fucking approach me because I've got some batshit insane problem with me. I've
yeah.
gone for that look.
I don't think see people give you crap, but I really don't think it looks that bad. But I like the main thing, I don't like shaving. It's fucking ball-like. Like I've got some clippers that I'll shave it down with every so often, but like fuck it, I don't care.
I'm literally going through a phase, probably like Ross, where I'm seeing how far my facial hair can go.
Yeah.
Because I've got to a point where it gets itchy and shit and I shave it.
Just keep going.
I'm
just
gonna keep going
yeah,
and see what happens.
Shape it.
It's never gonna grow on my cheeks properly.
It'll
it
come,
might.
Mate. It'll come.
So just,
if not implants from a monkey.
Implants. Cheek implants.
Cheek implants from a monkey's ass.
Yeah. Cool. Well, that's the beard thing covered.
Well, that's any other.
Ross, go. You're on the page.
Are we doing all of these?
Yeah, fuck it. Just
we've done enough Pokemon.
Camera 3, mate.
Oh, you don't have to if you don't.
I'm going
to
choose a random one.
Just skip to the next one if you don't like that one.
Okay, that's for Smith. Let's see. Kristen. At Great Story BJD
nice.
Says, Smith, would you get another reptile someday or stick with geckos?
Yeah, no, I'd love, like, the thing is, like, first of all, limitation of space, and B, you know, like, you got to make sure you can look after the ones you got before you get a ton more. But yeah, my housemate might be getting a crested gecko, which are really, really cool.
Got weird eyes.
Yeah.
Look like brains.
But yeah, no, I'm really interested in it. I think, again, if it's one of those situations where it's like, oh, when I've got a load of money or whatever, like I'd love to have like a room with lots of interesting things in it, but at the same time it's kind of like a bit of sweet because it's really cool to have these things, but at the same time you're quite kind of perpetuating captivity.
Yeah,
it kind of sucks. So
also they need a very some like, of them need very specific
yeah I'd love a chameleon and but you can't handle them at all and shit like that. Anyway, yeah, that's that.
So yes.
Wait, oh, so you did just ask that one?
Yeah,
for me. Right, okay, cool. All right, Katie says, what's your favorite Pokemon and why? It's Katie Smith
_777.
Mine would have to be Lamput, because he's a fucking lamp and it's like the laziest Pokemon I've ever seen ever. Hey, look, it's a lamp. You've done that in a Pokemon, you're alright.
Or Klefki, just a pair of keys.
Pair of fucking keys.
A set of keys.
There's so much shit in Pokemon.
Oh, man.
I like Marill.
Okay.
Or Azurill, the pre-evolution.
Oh.
If you breed a Marill and an Azumarill together, or two of the same types, make sure it's male and female, you get an Azurill. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, brilliant.
Jesse Pinkman says, when the almighty Hat Corp takes over the world, who will you enslave? Probably everybody that we can, I imagine, and they'll all become legit builder department.
Great pension, though.
Great pension scheme. So Ross?
Let's see. Sorry, I went on to the
You're terrible.
Page. I went on to another page. I'm so sorry.
Why would you
what's the best book you've ever read, Hat Chat? From
best
Zoe
book.
King.
That's
what
from
about
Zoe
series?
Lizzie King.
Okay, Smith?
Oh, fuck, it's hard as hell.
Don't say about that. We're talking about books.
I don't know. Anything by Brandon Sanderson?
Yeah, pretty much. I'm going to say the same.
That's pretty much my favourite.
I'm really enjoying the Stormlight Archive right now.
Yeah, Stormlight Archive's incredible.
Great.
All that Mistborn.
He's good at world building.
I mean, Game of Thrones is fucking fantastic as well. Game of Thrones is definitely up there, but I think Brandon Sanderson pips in the post simply because he's written so much that's so good.
Yeah. Ross?
The back page of the Sun. No, I would say the Game of Thrones because that's probably the best books I've actually read. But
cool.
Even then, I haven't read all of them.
Harry Potter.
I don't read that much, but I should really do that.
You loved Harry Potter, didn't you, Smith?
I loved Harry Potter.
Harry Potter's great. Harry Potter's classic.
Only when I was, you know, you grow out of it. It's still, yeah, exactly. It's fantastic, but there's just so much better fantasy.
You try reading Lord of the Rings.
Fantasy.
Yeah, it's fucking horrible. I really hate reading Lord of the Rings.
No, yeah. It's not great.
I read a book called Gormenghast once. Yep. That was one hell of a... That was...
Did you watch the series? The TV series?
I watched the TV series,
it was,
yeah,
fucking good.
It was good watching it, and then I thought, oh, I'll read it as well. And I was like, Jesus Christ, there's one fat book. And I was like, oh.
Other ones include Good Omens and Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy is great. Blah, 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 that's enough. Emma Payne, Yoggernaut HF says, who is the best dancer?
Trot. Best, yeah, in terms of kind of...
Out there,
to watch.
Ridiculous, yeah, stupid dancing.
I think it's like technical skill versus like... well, along with just like, you know, willingness to do it.
Yeah.
Trot is always there cutting shapes, yeah, like, yeah, you wouldn't believe.
You just gotta just go with the flow.
As much as I wish I could dance, I'm just too tall and big and heavy to make it look good.
I think the bigger and more you can flay your arms to the point of dislocation, the better.
The better you how you get in there, yeah.
That's how you get better at dancing.
Yeah.
Ross?
Sorry, I just saw someone really quickly saying, is Ross the only editor ever? No, we all edit. I don't know who that was, but
who was that?
Just so you know that we all do edit. It's a pet peeve when people don't think we do work when we are non-stop working.
Yeah, we yeah, we all have our own series. So, for example, Smith does old-fashioned bashing and trials.
I do
the Minecraft.
He's on
Having
a Bash as well, which is out tonight.
Yeah, mm. the Battlefield
and last Battlefield one.
I did the pancake vid, for example, but we all sort of rotate the live action stuff. And also the Minecraft stuff. I do that. And Ross does GTA. Both the series.
Yeah.
And live action stuff as well.
Live action stuff. Other stuff. There's always,
we all have
something to
stuff.
Do.
And there's always trailers.
Cornerstone's the only thing we've really got edited for us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good, because it allows us to do other things.
It's
the
first ever, and it's weird.
Yeah.
Shani 41188 says, okay, nukes have hit. You've got your cheeky barge. You can each save one luxury item. What do you choose?
That's a good question.
That is a good question.
I'd
one
have to
luxury
use
item.
Really, really practical.
Not useful, but luxury.
Something that doesn't a big knife, like a parang or something like that. Like
I guess chopping trees and yeah.
What about
yeah.
Like a Leatherman?
Yeah, well, multi-tools are useful, but only really, like...
They're very small.
Yeah, well, yeah, the thing about multi-tools is, yeah, the knife isn't particularly dangerous. You want something that's intimidating, like, you know, you want to be able to do a lot with it. You want to be able to kill someone with it. You want to be able to use it to
chop
meat. You know, so,
and
like,
that's the first thing
a good machete would probably
time
be it.
Is the murder weapon.
Huh?
I love that instead of just the instinct of survival, your first thing is to just think about how
because
the
instinct
kill
of survival
person.
Is to be able to kill other things.
Yeah. And killing pigs and
yeah, exactly.
Them.
Like I'm mainly thinking like, you know, fucking bears. Like you don't want to try and take on a bear with a 3-inch.
You don't
want
to try and really try and take on a bear ever because Christ.
I'd feel more comfortable knowing I've got a big fat machete on me.
Yeah, which leads me like so something useful, practical, and multi-purpose.
Is that a luxury item you own?
Which is why I choose a flashlight.
Huh?
That's not
glow in the dark though.
Function.
Glow in the dark, nice.
Yeah,
so you can always find
it's
it.
A torch.
Yep. Yeah,
it's a blunt weapon. And it's a
really
pleasure
blunt.
Device.
Pleasure. Nice.
I reckon if I hit a tree enough, I chop one down too. So
nice.
Multi-purpose.
How heavy are they? I mean, as a blunt weapon, is that?
I don't
be
know. I've never actually.
If you got like the super sized one, like a
yeah.
sized one,
and fantasy dragon one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
fantasy dragon one.
Yeah,
like so it's like having sex with a dragon.
Yeah, it's blue.
The clop one. He's got
you
the clop
get avatar
well.
Ones
clop
too.
One.
Cop. yeah, so that's my luxury item of choice. Nice, Ross. Or Smith?
Well,
has Ross
pick
done
a
your
question.
Luxury item yet?
I would just say a hammock.
So kay. Shit. Why a hammock? Okay. Why a hammock?
Because I can strangle someone with it. And I can lay in it above all of you guys on the floor.
Yeah,
I'd be like, hey.
You could do like...
two
know,
trees,
why
yes
not
please.
Just like a long piece of rope.
Yeah, you can take the strings apart and those long pieces of rope as well. Practical later on. When you decide, actually, no, I don't want to sleep in this.
I'd love to actually do a survival thing and just give you a hammock. And
yeah, and see how far I get.
Should we do that? We should do a survival
hammock,
thing.
Hammock, machete, hilarious. And a flashlight, a torch, whatever it's called.
Combined, guys, we're fucking sorted. Any sort of scenario, you're right.
Shock, can I borrow your flashlight?
Yeah, what, overnight? No worries.
Trade. Right, Bethany R. At Braycoon. Says Hatchat, will we be seeing no she doesn't say
this is the hashtag
will we be seeing the return of Filthy Animals Filthy Mods soon? And yeah, we've got a 6-part. We've spoken about it briefly.
I wouldn't say soon, but yeah, it's a pipeline thing as always.
We've got a 6-part series that's going to hopefully be going out via Polaris.
Okay. Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
What?
There's that.
Yeah.
That could.
Well, we've already spoken about it before.
Have we?
Yeah.
One of the rules. One of the rules of our last podcast was to never promise.
No,
we're
never taking anything as a promise.
Because if everything falls in, it's not happening.
But yeah, the 6-part thing we've got.
It's planned.
It's really fucking cool.
It just needs to be done, which is hard as we're doing lots of stuff. But yes, we aren't seeing the end of Filthy Animals.
Yeah, we do want to bring it back because it's good fun.
Foch is.
Other stuff getting in the way, which, again, mentioning the editing earlier on, like, it's good that we can have things edited for us in the office, like Cornerstone, because that then allows us to move that time elsewhere, such as working on Filthy Animals, doing cool one-offs like, you know, that Scotland trip and the pancake stuff and et cetera, et cetera.
Pokemon
crazy videos. So, yeah. Filthy Animals hopefully will return.
Yep. And last one, Amy at Yame23, who is your favourite character in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.? Trot, if you don't watch it, then who is your favourite Avenger?
Go on, Trot, you first.
Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., all those little clone guys, I don't know what they are, but there's loads of them. They're my favourite in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Who's your favourite?
My favourite Avenger is Iron Man.
Iron Man is pretty cool.
Simply because he has a really badass life.
Yeah.
Yeah, true.
He's got everything down. And everyone knows who he is. You want to be the Hulk, Ross?
I don't want to be. Was the question?
No, it's not. Who's your favorite?
I'll go Black Widow. Is that the one?
Because you like Scarlett Johansson.
Not Scarlett Johansson. She's the worst one.
She's got two shitty
little pistols.
Yeah. Compared to like Hulk and Iron Man.
Well, he already said Iron Man. I don't want to say Iron Man again.
Well, there's others. There's Thor.
Fuck Thor. And his.
There's Hawkeye, which is shitty. Hawkeye's pretty shitty. There is also technically Spider-Man now that Sony have made a deal with Marvel. Spider-Man's in Avengers.
Spider-Man's pretty cool.
Spider-Man's shit.
Can't wait for his third retelling of the origin story, am I right?
I can't wait for another one. And then another one after that.
Captain America's got quite a cool origin.
I haven't seen Captain America.
Some of the Captain America films are pretty
Winter, shit. Winter really Soldier's good.
Well, it's just he's a cool idea. He's like basically just like a Superman almost.
He got injected with similar stuff that Incredible Hulk did, but it actually
Wolverine?
Worked.
Can I choose Wolverine? He's not part of that, but
that's X-Men.
All right, I'm choosing Wolverine
in the Marvel universe.
All right,
what is your favorite thing?
I've chosen Wolverine. So
okay.
Let's deal with that.
Well, there you go. Wolverine's done.
What's your favorite themed fleshlight, Ross?
Dragon. What themes are there, Trump? Tell us.
There's a Hulk.
There's Hulk. It's all the Avengers.
It gets bigger the more you go at it.
Thor, which has
that sounds horrible. That sounds like a horrible sales pitch.
Oh, you know those.
It gets bigger as you use.
And more angry, angry
it gets
vibrations.
Angry and goes green. What?
That's just not washing it. Cool. That was the questions. Thanks everybody for sending them in.
There are plenty of other questions that we can't answer now. So thanks for sending those in or tweeting us. We do have a subreddit if you want to go there and send awesome fan art and other stuff.
Just get involved in the community.
Always.
Our community is amazing.
/r/
Hatfilms.
Hatfilms.
If you know Reddit.
Just, you know, go on there and, you know,
flesh it out with cool stuff.
Don't ask us repetitive questions because that's an issue.
And so, always look both ways when you cross a road.
Smith? Any wise advice for someone?
Sage advice. Yeah, keep an eye on the Russians.
Yeah.
Watch out. Exactly. Especially ones that you think aren't Russian.
Yeah.
Could be a spy.
Keep one eye on the sky, one eye on the Russians.
Great, that's great. Oh, the music's coming in.
Oh, yeah, shit.
They can't hear it. I can hear it coming in.
Right, guys.
I hit bombs!
This is the evacuation moment.
Under the desks! Under the desks! Get away! He's gone! He's gone under the desks!
Oh, Smith's just gone under our desks. Is under yours, Trot?
Hello, mate.
Fancy a cheeky one?
He's saying, fancy a cheeky one.
I know, no, I can hear him. Under my desk.
Oh, the music's drowned us out. It's fine.
It's gone.
It's gone.
And we're clear.
And we're probably clear. I assume so.
I'm clearing you. Right, God, I'm starving.
Oh, I need a wee.
Okay, well, thanks for joining us on YouTube, everybody. We hope you've enjoyed it.
3, 2, 1, and start.
Okay, stream started.
He started.
Okay, the stream started now.
Here we go again.
So now we're going to start the stream. Anyone who's just tuned in, that was a joke. So, sorry, we've actually just done an hour and 5 minutes.
So this, the people asking, this is going to be uploaded in full.
This, iTunes, right? This stream is going to go on YouTube.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Pre-recorded, so you'll if you missed any of it, you'll be able to skip back.
And just watch it again.
And watch it again. And also, it's going to go on iTunes if you prefer to have it on your phone or your iPod or whatever. Mm-hmm. We have an iTunes playlist, which is in the link of this description. So go check that out.
So do all those things. Download it.
And we'll subscribe. Join us next time, right?
Like the video and
join us next time for another one in a few, you know, weeks time, maybe a month or so. Who knows?
Yeah, if you got the chance, like the video because that does help the algorithms and shit. So that helps us a bunch. Thanks a bunch, guys, for tuning in for our crazy war-themed hat chat. And we'll see you on the next one. Yeah.
Be sure to watch Battlefield Hardline going out later on tonight
at 9 o'clock tonight. See you later.
Bye. Oh.